This is a good thing for men to actually say what bothers them, how they're insecure, whether they're man enough, whether they're big enough, whether they're long enough, whether they're happy enough, whether they're... Come on. What do you think?
I think that orgasm isn't the only thing in sex. And that's what they're alluding to.
It's true.
It's the massage that
Speak
you give
whatever
before...
whatever second place.
But for women, it's not the only thing.
Yeah, but don't you feel like it's a really big part of it, though?
It's a part of it.
It's not the only thing.
But the nurturing is the main part for me. Yes. The nurturing, the hugging.
Are you actually saying that if you were with a man and all the massages and the kisses and the affection and the conversation and all that was great and you didn't have an orgasm, that you would be fulfilled and satisfied at the end of that time?
I don't know.
You would?
Really?
I think you finally got it. I think what men don't realize is that for men it's physical, and for women it's much more emotional. There's a lot more in it for a woman.
I completely disagree. I think that there's a time and a place for both.
Oh, you young people are all alike.
Sometimes people need to be nurtured, both men and women, and other times we have our animalistic physical needs, and there's a time and a place for both.
Animalistic.
Wow.
Sometimes.
Hang on, just one second.
Yes. Yes.
Well, I'm 17 and I'm not sexually active yet, but with my boyfriends, at this point with my boyfriends, I mean, it's lots more than sex. I mean, I go out with them to movies, we have a good time. Maybe it's something different when you get into a marriage, but I think that you should be able just to enjoy the time you spend with somebody and that it's not all physical.
Mm-hmm.
Is it difficult to convey this notion to the boys that you did?
Sometimes, but when you're in a relationship and a guy really cares about you, the more he loves you, the less interested he is in sex. Most of the time, at least in my relationships, the men I've gone out with.
I don't know about that.
You know? I mean, he wants to. I mean, he likes to.
I understand your point. I think what she's saying, you'll correct me, of course.
Okay.
The more you feel about the guy, and the more mutual it is, the more he's going to respect your...
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. That's exactly it.
Yes.
I just want to say, you know, it's like, it's not either or. My wife wants all of it.
Everything.
She wants everything.
Right.
She doesn't want, do you want a little nurturing, a little... No, she wants everything, and she's very upfront about that. And I do my best to give it to her. And if she doesn't get the nurturing, she complains. And if she doesn't get the orgasm, she complains, too.
Yeah, I agree with what she said about sometimes having to have that animalistic, for lack of a better word.
Yeah.
You know, to have that need in a relationship. Because, you know, sometimes nurturing is very important. Not taking anything away from what she said. But the lust, has got to be there, too. And it's already a given that people are, are mentally closed, I think, if they're in a marriage or a relationship that is long-lasting.
I agree. Frank Pittman, MD. Boy, we need you. You're a psychiatrist. It's about time you get out here. Help us here. First of all, you, not unlike the large body of scholarship within the psychiatric community, make the point that who we are sexually has a lot to do with how we're raised, the relationship that we had with mom and dad. And you say, among other things, for a couple of hundred years now, each generation of fathers has passed on less to his sons. Not just less power, but less wisdom and less love. We have finally reached a point where most fathers are largely irrelevant in the lives of their sons. Well, we could do several shows on that, but so what? How does that influence this?
Because it leaves men not knowing how to be men. The only way in which we can learn how to be a man is from men. We can't learn how to be a man from women. We can't learn how to be a man.
Okay. And what is flawed about this instruction now?
If our fathers don't raise us, then we're raised by our mothers.
Right.
And we're raised in a world in which women have all the power, in which women define us as men, in which our sense of our masculinity is no longer coming from ourselves, it's coming from how women respond to us. Uh-huh. We then spend the rest of our lives dependent upon getting a woman to respond to us. Getting a woman to love us, getting a woman to be satisfied with us, and getting a woman to reassure us constantly that she won't abandon us. Because if she abandons us, if she fails to be satisfied by us, if she fails to love us, then we cease to be men, because our masculinity is being defined by women.
This is very interesting. Now, incidentally, Dorothy Dinnerstein says this,
a very respected
feminist writer on these matters. No other person should be that important to any other. In other words, it's terrifying if women have this. What essentially we're doing then is giving an awful lot of power over our emotional well-being to women.
Absolutely. Our whole life is in the hands of women.
And so we shouldn't be surprised then that, first of all, we're insecure. Mm-hmm. And if we, you know, and a lot of us are, if we become jobless, or if we put all our worth eggs in the basket of the attentions of a woman, and we start to feel down, or we feel that we're going to blame her, and, you know, this could be at the root of domestic violence.
Absolutely. It's at the root of all of these problems. It is an idiotic, insane notion that women can raise sons to become men. Because if women raise boys, when they become men, they're so dependent upon women, they're scared. They're having to perform for them. Sex becomes a job.
Please them. Please
we
them.
Have to please them. We have to keep satisfying them. We have to understand them.
That's scary. That's fascinating. You women are in our master control room. And we hate you for this. We don't want you to have this power. No.
I disagree very strongly with the psychologist.
Tell me.
I would not want to be involved with a man who learned how to be sexual from his father.
Because,
and that's what you're saying.
Because the fathers are sexist jerks?
Well, he started off his discussion by saying that a man learns how to become masculine from his father. And if a man that I'm dating learned how to be sexual from his father, then that would mean that their family was seriously dysfunctional.
I'll give you a chance to answer this young woman in just a moment.
The Connecticut School of Broadcasting could be what you've been waiting for. Thousands of graduates have already been placed in radio and TV jobs all across the country. Learn by doing from the pros.
Thanks to the Connecticut School of Broadcasting, I have a career, not just a job. Thanks, CSB.
The Connecticut School of Broadcasting and Independence. Call today at 447-9117. 447-9117.
Hi, I'm Jim Palmer. There's still time to refinance your home at the Money Store, even if you have less than perfect credit. Over the last year, thousands of homeowners across America have refinanced their mortgages with the Money Store. You can apply by phone anytime at the Money Store, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and there's never an application fee. So to refinance your mortgage, even if your credit is less than perfect, call the Money Store at 1-800-LOAN-YES. The Money Store, where America goes for money.
At Burger King, 2 plus 2 equals 1.99.
I love this place!
It's the new Burger King Everyday Value Menu, with many of your favorite Burger King foods at new, lower everyday prices. And now, 2 flame-broiled burgers and 2 orders of golden fries for $1.99.
They look delicious.
Check your Burger King for their everyday low prices. And now, for a limited time, 2 great-tasting flame-broiled burgers and 2 small fries for $1.99. Value every day. Have it your way.
I love this place!
Something very different is happening at Cleveland News at 11 o'clock. Channel 3 is bringing you more news than any other station.
Now, we know that's a tough promise to live up to, but if you'll compare Channel 3 to the other stations, you'll see our commitment.
We have more coverage of local stories and a fresh approach to bringing Cleveland the news.
We have more news for you.
If you watch us tonight at 11, you'll see proof.
We're building our station around you. I'm Connie Deacon. This is Channel 3 News at 11.
Tonight, the city of Cleveland.
Go get them, Doc. You're being challenged here. I think you've been misunderstood, incidentally.
Not completely, because if a man gets his sense of himself as a man from women, then it's too overwhelming. If he has a sense of himself as a man that comes from his relationship with his father, from his camaraderie with other men, then he can learn about sex from women. He can get his sexuality in the relationship with a woman, rather than having to get his whole identity, his whole self, from that relationship. That gives her too much power, and it puts so much burden on the sexuality, that his whole identity, his whole self, his whole relationship is being supported by his penis and by her response to it. That's too much power.
You know what, too? I'll tell you something. Honestly, I think all parents everywhere should tell their sons to respect women. We agree. But I'll tell you something else I really believe. I think it's more influential and effective if the father does it.
I have one more question.
Sure, go ahead. Why not? This is America.
Okay. Yes. Towards the end of your discussion, you said that you believe there's some sort of relationship to violence against women.
I said that. I wondered, if we're going to make you this powerful, if you're going to be that much in charge of how we feel about ourselves, then sooner or later we're going to get very, very angry at you. That's the problem.
That's right.
And some of us, either because we drink too much or because we're really intimidated by this or because we're totally for whatever it is, we'll beat you up. And it's happening all over America.
I agree with you that violence against women is widespread, but I don't think that we can point to that as the sole cause. We have to look at the abuse that the man himself underwent that led him to abuse others.
Very good point. I think the doctor would agree.
There are a lot of causes, but the most measurable reason for men to be violent to women is that they've been raised without fathers. They get their sense of identity from escape from women. They have to be sure that they don't come under the power of women. They see women as too powerful, and they're scared.
Paul, you were raised by a single mother, right?
Well, actually, basically, yeah.
All right, give me a chance.
Yeah,
I'm going to give you a chance to speak to this theory and this observation. And also to the professor here, who seems to know more about this. And we'll be back in just a moment.
You're the slowest person I ever met.
Well, my original syrup is so deliciously thick and rich, it takes more time to pour than maple syrup, see?
Sure does, Mrs. Butterworth, but you're really worth it.
I got a problem.
Poor baby.
Yeah, watch.
Well, I've got a solution.
Country Crock spreadable sticks.
Yeah, they spread easy, straight from the fridge.
Very spreadable.
Very edible.
New Country Crock spreadable sticks spread easy, straight from the fridge.
Deep down inside, we knew it could happen, but I think we're ready for it.
I think it's just we're a little scared. But I believe because of the length of time we've been together, and because we know each other so well, that we feel that we can face it, and that we're prepared.
Can we look?
I'm shaking.
Oh, I knew it. Congratulations. You happy?
Mm-hmm.
Babies are life's most precious gift, and they deserve to be born healthy. Mom, why don't you call Healthy Family Healthy Start? It is important for you to see a doctor and get early prenatal care. The Greater Cleveland Healthy Family Healthy Start Project supports the entire family. If you are pregnant or know someone who is, pick up the phone and call 664-HFHS for more information, because all babies deserve a healthy start.
Automotive emergency.
911.
At Clark Ford, 911 new and used vehicles must be sold by month's end. Choose from over 1,500 new Tempos, Escorts, Thunderbirds, Crown Vicks, Taurus, F-150s, Rangers, Explorers, Aerostars, even conversion vans. Get emergency 3.9% fixed rate financing up to 60 months. Every credit application will be processed during this automotive emergency. When Clark Ford,
Mr. Big Volume,
declares an automotive emergency,
911.
You save thousands.
Coming up tonight on Channel 3 News at 6.
The trial of two teenagers charged with arson and murder comes to a painful end for the victim's father.
And this explosion made Chucky Hoffman an orphan. But after today, he may be closer to having a home.
Also, after last week's devastating flood, some of the residents of Rocky River have found themselves in an even greater predicament.
Their plight could be a lesson to anyone who lives near the river. Don't miss our flood follow-up report.
That's tonight at 6.
To be a part of the audience, please send a postcard for free tickets to Donahue Tickets, care of NBC, 30 Rockefeller Plaza, New York, New York, 10112. Remember, postcards only, please. Be sure to include your phone number with area code.
Paul, make your point.
Actually, I didn't come up with a single mother. I grew up with a family, but my mother really was like the nurturing relationship that I grew from, so to speak. My dad was kind of doing his deal, and
Well, that's pretty normal.
And the thing I was talking before the show about was that my mom and I had a conversation about a week ago, and we're at the table, and she goes, "You're never going to have a relationship that works with a woman or a wife until you complete your relationship and make it work with me."
Is that right, Doc?
That is right.
No kidding.
That's right. A man has to satisfy his mother and feel that he really is good enough to please her before he can be completely into a relationship with another woman. He's got to get over his fear that he's let her down.
Who wants to talk about that? Well, hang on just a second. This is another way of saying it's mom's fault. Everything's mom's fault.
It's dad's
mom
fault.
Mom made me do it.
No, dad's
fault. I'm in death row and it's my mother's fault.
It's the absence of father.
I've been divorced 5 times. It's my mother's fault. I'm an alcoholic. It's my mother's fault.
It's the father's fault for running out on fathering. We've somehow gotten a definition of masculinity for the last few generations that have carried men away from fathering. And ultimately, away from families altogether. Instead, we have men trying to make themselves feel man enough by seducing large numbers of women that they're scared of, satisfying them in every imaginable way, turning it into some sort of contest between him and the other guys to see who can have the most orgasms or who can have the longest or the biggest this, that, or the other. They're trying to feel like they're men by using a sexual relationship when a sexual relationship should be loving and fun
equal,
and enjoyable.
Equal.
And equal.
Mutually.
Above all, equal.
I just know from experience of being with men that usually the way a man treats his mother is the way he's going to treat his girlfriend or his wife in the future.
That's so. Right. That's right. If he's scared of her,
hang on just a second. Do you learn anything about you're single?
No, I'm married.
Before you were married, did you learn anything about the guys that you dated by meeting their fathers?
Well,
how many fathers did you meet?
Well, I meet the fathers, but usually they'll wind up being like their fathers. If their fathers are lazy, they'll usually end up being lazy or fat and bald, you know. That's what you get from your father.
I don't think it's the problem with the fathers here. Look at the Kennedy family, for God's sake. I mean, you have plenty of role models, and look what they're doing. It's like aluminum siding, for God's sake.
Phil, I want to make a comment here.
Go ahead.
Touching on what the doctor said, I'm currently unemployed, and I am at home with my twin boys all day, every day. I'm changing diapers, feeding, and all that kind of thing. And that's pretty good, but let me say that. I even start to feel insecure at some moments because I feel that as a man, it is my duty to go out and make the bacon and bring it home. Okay, and I'm not saying that my wife shouldn't be doing the same thing, but I feel that as a man, that's what I should be doing. Now my question is that the right way to feel? Should I be happy with being at home with the boys?
The most important thing that a man can do in life is be a father to his children. A woman can be God or Pope or Prime Minister or anything else. The only thing a woman can't do is be a father. The most important thing in your kids' lives is not that you make money for them, but that you be there with them, that you hang out with them. That's going to mean so much to them.
I think that what we're doing, we're not saying that fathers have to be there and that they shouldn't be there. I found the guys that I've dated that I've enjoyed being with the most had excellent relationships with their fathers. The ones that didn't have a good relationship with their dad were the ones that you really didn't want to see anymore.
No.
Right. I agree completely.
And we'll be back in just a moment.
Remember me? I'm the fellow that told you to use your blow dryer to soothe an earache. That was just one of the hundreds of special doctor-tested home remedies from one of the most famous and useful books we ever put together, Until Now. This is the brand new doctor's book of home remedies, too. Hi, I'm Bill Gottlieb, editor-in-chief. And believe me, if you want even more of the most effective home healing techniques from even more of the best doctors, covering even more health problems and conditions, then call for the doctor's book of home remedies, too, right now. You'll get so many practical remedies, all from top health experts. Like if you get a paper cut, heal it with super glue. Or to remove your ring from a swollen finger, use dental floss. And to make age spots disappear, try lemons. From relieving pizza burn on the roof of your mouth to popping out a splinter without using a needle. It's all here in the new Doctor's Book of Home Remedies 2.
The Doctor's Book of Home Remedies 2. Over 600 pages. 1,800 home healing remedies from 700 doctors and health experts.
There's so much that's new in the Doctor's Book of Home Remedies 2. Like how eating nuts can help end migraines. How taking cough syrup can increase your fertility. Even why using a dark tablecloth can actually help you lose weight.
Call now for the new Doctor's Book of Home Remedies 2. Try it absolutely free for 21 days. Then if you wish to keep it, pay in just four easy installments of only $6.99.
And as a free gift, you'll get this special book, Anti-Aging Nutrients, about the foods and nutrients that can help you reverse the effects of aging.
Remember, you can try the Doctor's Book of Home Remedies 2 free for 21 days.
By the way, try a wet tea bag for sore gums. Or to relieve heel spurs, wear cowboy boots. If you get a leg cramp,
call now, 1-800-643-7700. That's 1-800-643-7700. For a transcript of Donahue, send $3 to Journal Graphics, 1535 Grant Street, Denver, Colorado, 80203. Or call 303-831-9000. To order a video cassette for only $24.95, just call 1-800-FOR-VIDEO.
Yes, hi, you
want to say? Hi, I just have a question for the doctor. I just want to ask you, do you think that if a man was raised by his mother, he'll have a better understanding of women and he'll respect them better? Don't you think that's true?
If a man is raised by his mother, he's overwhelmed with the power of women. He doesn't get his identity. He's got to get his identity from a man.
That's a valid point. Well, now we're going to
have to break out here. Bill, I want to say something about that.
Well, here comes Solomon. Stand by for a long speech here.
First of all, I want to tell all you guys.
Go ahead.
You know, all you're doing here is you've got this fixation of how do I please a woman? I'm so worried about this. I'm so worried about that. You know, sex is my be-all and end-all. Do I please her? You guys forgot what it's like to be men. You guys forgot what it's like that a woman looked at you the way you walked or what you did or what you said.
Are you married?
No, I'm happy.
Can I just make this point?
Yeah, hold that mic for thanks.
It has happened now for the 26 years we've been on the air. Women will stand and ask a question, to be sure, offer an opinion, but men are more likely to stand in this audience and say, I don't know what you guys are talking about. Here's the answer to all this.
Right.
What are you guys talking about? And they start to pontificate. You are pontificating.
No, I don't believe I don't believe so because what you're doing here is, and it's nice to be considerate of women. It's nice to know whether you're going to, you know, they're going to achieve an orgasm or not. But on the other hand, you know, it's a basic chemistry between the two of them. You can't be so preoccupied whether they're going to have an orgasm or so on and so forth. And for the guy with the beard, a watched pot never boils. You know, don't be so preoccupied with it. It's a chemistry. Women, if they didn't like
you,
if they didn't
charge for this. I think he's a watch pot. I think he's an honest man. He's acknowledging a problem that is, I think, a circumstance which certainly is on the minds of most people his age. He's told us he's 76. Most men at age 76 begin to wonder about this, too, you know?
I want to respond to what
go ahead. Go ahead and said. Respond.
What I've noticed in the last couple of years about how I relate to women and men is that it's in the area of sex, it's completely automatic. The sex part's automatic. We don't have to think about it. And I think there's something more available when you challenge that automaticity that males have.
I do too.
So
do
he too. Didn't address that for me, and that's what I've been working on. So, you know, I think it's really important for a relationship.
Dr. Pittman's book is titled Man Enough, Fathers, Sons, and the Search for Masculinity. This is a very well-drawn account of not only his own experience as a professional, as a medical person, but a lot of other people you include with appropriate attribution in your book. Listen to this. Men don't sleep around because they have imperfect marriages. They may, but that is not the reason that they're unfaithful. Listen to this. Men sleep around because they don't feel man enough. The roots of infidelity are in the defective relationship between a man and his
father.
and his father. Not a defective marriage. No kidding.
That's right. That's right.
Show me a man who has a dysfunctional relationship with his father, and I'll show you a guy who screws around.
I think that's right. The likelihood is enormous that a man who didn't really get that sense of himself as a man from his father is going to be scared of women, scared of his mother, and is going to be looking for women he hasn't hurt yet. Women who still see him as a hero, because the wife that he's got knows him, all of his flaws, all of his warts.
Doesn't mean it always has to be true.
No,
you
want
to
know.
There are exceptions to this.
Every person is different.
Every person is different. But on average, he is saying this is to be found underneath a man who is not faithful. And we'll be back to let you argue this case in just a moment.
Why aren't you flexing your teeth?
Flexing?
With Aquafresh Flex, the only toothbrush designed with a flexible neck. Flex helps you brush away plaque, yet it's still gentle to your gums. Look, it doesn't even damage this tomato. So stop brushing and start flexing.
Presenting some more of the 2,000 body parts you can clean with Lever 2000, the deodorant soap that's better for your skin and all your 2,000 parts. Lever 2000, now in new unscented.
The law offices of Dan Whittington and Associates.
Serious injuries are something no one expects. But if you or a loved one has been permanently disabled due to someone's carelessness, you need legal help that can't come from the insurance company. I'm Dan Whittington. You can discuss it with us for free. In fact, that's our policy for everyone who's been injured. At the time you need it most, we're on your side.
Dan Whittington and Associates, on your side.
$1.99, you can get this Hot Rod Williams growth chart at Pizza Hut. It won't make you any taller or quicker. It won't make you jump any higher or dunk any harder.
But it sure can make your room look cool.
The Hot Rod Williams growth chart. It won't make you taller, but it might give you something to shoot for. Now, at Pizza Hut.
To be a part of the audience, please send a postcard for free tickets to Donahue Tickets, care of NBC, 30 Rockefeller Plaza, New York, New York, 10112. Remember, postcards only, please. Be sure to include your phone number with area code.
No, go ahead. You want to ask your question? Go ahead.
Just a comment, actually, for the doctor, that we were just talking here about, that when children are born, they don't have a choice whether they have a mother or a father. And I think a lot of the points that you're making are semi-valid. But you're leaving out a lot of children, a lot of children.
And I think that's why we have so much infidelity, so much divorce, and so much violence.
A lot of mothers are raising children and do not have fathers and don't have options for strong male role models.
Those boys are being terribly disadvantaged.
So what's the solution?
And they're going to have an even harder time than the six of us, because I got the same problem.
What's the solution? We talk up here. We can all hypothesize about the problem. What's the solution?
Well, go ahead. Take the shot.
Yeah, well, you know, at some point, when you're a man, you say to grow up and listen and do what you got to do.
That's simple, Simon. You can't this is not about saying it. It's about it coming from the inside and being meaningful and long-lasting. Doc!
The main thing that we have to do, understand our fathers, forgive our mothers for loving us too much, but then open ourselves up to the other guys. If we as men are sharing these fears, then we won't be so isolated. But most important of all, is to reveal ourselves totally to the women in our lives so that we can make it equal rather than hiding from them. We spend so much of our life trying to perform for them, doing a job for them, trying to satisfy them, pacifying them, while we're still wanting them to see us as strong, tough, and heroic. If we can let them know what it feels like to be us, then maybe the relationship won't be so dependent on the numbers and the sizes and the durations of things.
I agree with that, but I think back to the dysfunctional behavior between men and women. I think it starts at birth when the father and the double standards in the home. Yes. Men do this and women do this. You are definitely man enough because you're at home taking care of your children. You're unemployed, but that's okay because everyone in a relationship, it takes two. If you're not working, you're not working, but someone is, so it doesn't matter.
Good. Well, thank you. Thank you. And you're cured, so you can leave.
If there's a lack of male in the home, the father image, right, then don't coaches and scoutmasters and teachers then become more important?
Absolutely. And grandfathers and uncles and your friends' fathers and any man you can find. That's but good. Women have to understand, if they're single mothers, that they've got to bring men into this kid's life, because he's going to be in trouble if he doesn't have men that he's connected with.
I'll give you a chance to answer your question.
Well, my comment...
In just a moment. Oh. I'm sorry.
Finding your way through today's mortgage market is difficult. That's why you should call Centennial Mortgage Company. Whether you're buying a new home, refinancing at today's lower interest rates, or consolidating high-interest debt into a home equity loan, do what tens of thousands of homeowners have already done. Call Centennial now. Because Centennial has many ways to help find the right mortgage for you. Call Centennial. You'll be glad you did.
When you shop Sun TV, you'll always find super savings, courteous service, and an unbeatable selection on thousands of brand new, brand name products. Plus, our lowest certified price guarantee assures you that Sun's prices won't be beat. This Kelvinator washer-dryer pair is just $377. This Frigidaire 18 cubic foot refrigerator is only $397. And this 22 foot Roper side-by-side is just $777. The best savings, service, and selection are at Sun TV, where you know you pay less.
My name is Lois. I want to talk to you about something I just did. Something I've been meaning to do for some time. Find out more about Rogaine, you know, with minoxidil, whether it was for me. I'm telling you this because I think a lot of women may have the same questions I did. Well, now you know, you're not alone. Here, boy. Push your ball. Push your ball. And there is some good news. See, it's never been easier to find out about Rogaine, if it's for you. There's this 800 number you can call about Rogaine. They'll send you a free information kit prepared especially for women. It's filled with all kinds of facts to help answer your questions about Rogaine. And because you need a prescription to get Rogaine, they also send you a list of local doctors offering a free private consultation to help you decide if Rogaine is right for you. That's how I got my questions answered. I hope you decide to call. I know I'm really glad I did.
Call now 1-800-845-2553 for a free information kit. Princess Diana, forced out of public life. The charade is over. An exclusive look at Princess Di as you've never seen her before on the next Current Affair.
Tonight at 7 on Channel 3.
You're going to say life is great. I don't need you every goddamn day. No, no.
A father's pain as the boys who killed his daughter are sentenced. That story is next.
Married or about to be? Take this simple test to see if your marriage will end in divorce. Next, Donahue.
There it is. Man Enough is Dr. Frank Pittman's look at fathers, sons, and the search for masculinity. You wanted to say.
How many of these young men had wonderful relationships with their fathers?
With their fathers.
I do.
One, yeah. Two?
Have or had?
Had.
Had.
No, but see, that's two for five. That's...
It's okay. It's growing. It needs to be worked out.
You know, what kills me is the number of celebrities who are writing their biographies now, and they talk about their fathers were silent and angry and volcanic, and we've ruined the men of the world, I'll tell you. It's no wonder so many cultures drag women around by the hair. The men are insecure.
We got a crazy culture.
Services provided and promotional fees paid by the following. Ginsana, for active people. The only ginseng product scientifically tested for 25 years. All natural, no caffeine. Ginsana, for active people.
New Dromedary Bakery Bread Machine Mix. Just add water and let your bread machine do the rest. Freshly baked gourmet bread made simple. If it doesn't say made with real Fleischmann's yeast, it's not Dromedary Bakery.
Guest accommodations provided by the Drake Swiss Hotel on Park Avenue, New York's premier address for business or leisure, with guest rooms, suites, and conference rooms for up to 200 people. Call 1-800-DRAKE-NEW-YORK and ask about our special packages priced from $150.